It's Eva Cartman, and you're listening to the Dream Big Podcast Show, the place to go to learn, laugh, and grow. And today, I'm going to tell you what to do when you think that someone you care about is lying to you. You can't control the action of others, but you can control how you react, and that makes all the difference. My name is Eva Cartman. I'm part of a squad of super kids that are here to change the world. We don't believe you need to be adults to have big goals and start working towards your dreams. We believe age is just a number, and you're never too young to make a difference. We may be young, but we are not naive. We understand that achieving our big dreams will not be easy. It will take incredible dedication, hard work, and yes, massive action. There will be ups and downs, but we embrace the challenges and relish pushing outside of our comfort zone because this is how we grow. They may not teach us these concepts in our school textbooks, but we are smart enough to know that the tools and tactics to achieve our big dreams are out there. And we are willing to do the work to seek out these skills and master them because we know that our future depends on it. We are the big dreamers, and it's time to dream big. I hope you like the new intro. We are still planning to play our jingle for episodes where we interview someone, but we thought it would be fun to create a fresh intro for my solo episodes, which you'll be hearing more and more of. And today, I'll be answering a question from Nicole from Austin, Texas. Nicole writes, "Hi, Eva. I love the Dream Big podcast. I hope you can help give some advice on something that is really bothering me, and I can't seem to let it go. A few weeks ago, I found out that one of my best friends, Allison, lied to me, and I'm still fuming about it. She said she could not get together because her parents told her she had to stay home and do homework, but then I found out she was actually playing at another friend's house. I feel like I can't trust her anymore, and also hurt that she apparently wanted to hang out with someone else other than me. I don't like the fact that I am so mad about this, so I would love to get your advice on how I can forgive her." Thank you, Nicole, so much for your question. Being able to forgive is such an important skill, because if you can't let go of your anger, then that energy is going to hold you back from moving forward on whatever it is that is truly important to you. So I'm glad you asked the question and that you are being so honest about how you're feeling. One thing that you didn't mention is if you actually talk to her about it. When someone does something that bothers you, you should always have a conversation about it first. Sometimes you'll discover that you're making an assumption and getting upset over something that wasn't even intentional. As an example, here, let's say that Allison's parents did tell her she could not leave the house because she had not finished her homework. And then Allison sat down for 3 hours and worked nonstop until her homework was done. And then her parents said it was okay to see a friend. And even then, you should not assume that your friend chose to go somewhere else because they like that other friend more. Sometimes parents plan playdates for their kids and the kids don't even have a say in it. My point is, without even discussing what happened, you won't know whether there was a good reason for what happened. But let's say that you did talk to her about it and she did lie to you. How should you handle that? Well, first I will say that forgive and forget, which is a saying you may have heard before, is not the most practical advice. If someone breaks your trust, you can't force yourself to forget that ever happened. And actually, you should be more careful the next time around on trusting that person. But forgiveness is a separate step that you should do first and foremost as a gift to yourself, because it does not serve you to be angry and resentful towards the person. If you're putting your time and energy into being mad at your friend, you're wasting time that could be put towards having fun and moving towards your big dreams. Imagine that you're trying to reach your goal, which is like climbing to the top of a mountain. You want to be as light and free as possible. If anything is weighing you down, in this case the energy that you are putting on yourself by being angry at your friend for not telling the truth, then that is going to slow you down from getting to the mountaintop. You can relate to this because you know that the more gear you are carrying on your back, the harder and slower it is to move. Also, whenever something like this happens, you should always look at inspirational stories of forgiveness. And my dad and I did some research to share some examples. One of the most famous stories of forgiveness is of Nelson Mandela. he spent over 27 years in prison in South Africa, 27 of the prime years of his life behind bars for trying to stop discrimination in his country. Now, if you tried to imagine what it would be like to have 27 of the best years of your life stolen from you, you can see how when he got released, he could have been consumed with anger towards the racist regime that had thrown him in jail. But instead, he went on to publicly forgive those who jailed him and even invited one of the guards to the ceremony when he became president. Another incredible example of forgiveness was when Pope John Paul II forgave the man who shot him 4 times in an attempt on his life. He even went to visit the would-be assassin in his prison cell. Sometimes it is helpful to hear those incredible examples from history to realize that if forgiveness is possible in those situations, it should be possible for me to forgive here. And that is not saying that you should not be upset for what happened. Just to provide some perspective on that, if forgiveness can be achieved in such extreme situations, then you can find the strength to forgive as well. I do want to emphasize that when somebody you love betrays your trust, that does not mean you have to start believing them right away. Your friend will have to earn back your trust, so you should not be expected to forget that it happened. But you will want to forgive the person. And it is so important to stress that you are doing this first and foremost for yourself, for your own well-being. You don't want to be the kind of person that holds a grudge forever. First off, it is not good for your emotional state if you hold on to feelings of anger. That will impact your mood. It will affect your focus and ultimately your ability to achieve your dreams. My dad wanted to chime in with this quick story here.
Thanks, Eva. I just wanted to point out that not being able to forgive is something that adults also struggle with. This was always amazing to me, but when I was about Eva's age, I remember that my great-grandma and her sister, my great-aunt, had not talked for decades because of some argument they had when they were younger, and neither one of them would forgive the other, and it led to a ridiculous situation where they could not be in the same room together. And for super important family events like weddings, if they were both in the room, they would not even acknowledge the other person. No eye contact. There were rumors in the family that in their old age, they didn't even remember what it was they were fighting about. They were both just so stubborn and refused to forgive each other. I remember even as a young boy thinking how childish this behavior was and how selfish it was because of what it did to the family. So this inability to forgive is something that adults deal with too, and the fact that you're thinking about it at such a young age is really important. Also remember that no matter how high your standards are, you will get lied to at some point in your lifetime. It's going to happen. So learning how to deal with these feelings now is an important skill that will help you throughout your life.
Thanks, Dad. So to recap, here's the 3-step process we recommend. Number 1, recognize you are upset and hurt over the situation. You don't want to bury this anger inside of you. Number 2, recognize that you control your thoughts about the situation. So while what happened was hurtful, you get to decide if you are going to let that hurt consume you or if you are going to get back to being happy. Number 3, decide to forgive, first and foremost for yourself. If you are ever having difficulty doing this or you find those feelings creeping back into you, then focus your energy on your dreams. That will get your mind off it and let you make progress on something that is actually important. Here's a short rhyme my dad and I wrote, which you can get the full text to at dreambigpodcast.com/89 and read to remind yourself on how and why to forgive the next time someone disappoints you. Here's the rhyme, everyone. Over the course of your life, people will lie to you, and that's a guarantee. The quality of your life will depend on whether you can forgive or if you decide to stay angry. Nelson Mandela was unjustly in prison for 27 years, and let's not forget the Pope. John Paul visited and forgave the man who shot him 4 times. That kind of forgiveness should give us all hope. Because it proves that if they can forgive in those situations, then certainly so can you. In life, you can't control other people, but how you respond is entirely up to you. You can get consumed with anger. You've been betrayed. You're angry and you won't budge. What could be solved with a 5-minute conversation can turn into a destructive decades-long grudge. The better option is to forgive for your own sake. Just let it go. And all that energy can be redirected to your big dreams. Forgiving is how you will grow. Big Dreamers, I would love to hear if you have forgiven a friend or family member recently. And how did it make you feel? Head on over to dreambigpodcast.com/89 and let me know your thoughts. There, you'll also find a link to our limited time offer for a free customized Dream Big journal with your face and name, as well as a place to sign up for our newsletter, where you'll learn my top tips on making and keeping great friends. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is Eva Cartman reminding you that you have unlimited potential. Your dreams are not optional. You need to make them essential. So take massive action to turn those big dreams into reality. Live with passion, the way life is meant to be. See you in the next episode. Bye!